Hello everybody, how are you? I hope you're having a great day. A while back in a video I had where I showed you a tip where when you're using clings you can use tape to weed it. I also mentioned that I would show you how to take the images that are in a cartridge with snowflakes and separate them for those that might not know. So we're going to go to cartridges. By doing this, you're going to get about three to four per pattern. And I used about three sheets of clings making them for my front door. Had lots of fun once I knew that the tape would remove. Okay, I don't remember the name of it. It might be snowflakes. So we're going to give it a try. There they are. Look at all these wonderful snowflakes. Okay, but notice there's different colors. And what I was printing them on was a one color, the frosted. I think I did that one. I know I did this one. You choose the ones you want. Okay, let's start off with those. That's what, six snowflakes? And the best way to do this is select them all. And then I want to align them to the left. At the zero position. Okay. Then I've ungrouped them and then I'm going to spread them out. Let me minimize my screen some. For those of you that may not know how to do that, just click on minus. And I'm doing this just for teaching purposes. You don't have to do it that way. You could do one at a time. Close enough. Okay, let's see if I do this right. We can grab them all. And I could have hit select all up here. Then we're going to go to, oh, it's trying to group them. Never mind. We go separate. Ungroup. And then I'm going to pull them to the side. One, two. And this is where I should go up on the screen so you can see beautiful designs here. Now, this one is a snowflake, and this one I didn't use. If you want to, you could, but I took those off the screen. I didn't think they looked as nice as all the others. Okay, ungroup. The only thing that you can do to it. So ungroup. See how easy this is? Okay, this one I'm not going to include. Okay. and group. I did about 20 before I realized the tape method. Okay, I'm going to take that one out, and I'm going to take this one out, and this one out. So I only got two from that one. Ungroup. I'll show you why I'm trying to put them all in order in just a moment. And this is probably all that I'm going to show you just to save your time. Okay, that one really doesn't look too good. Let's leave this one. Okay, one more. Just to get that. And group. Ooh, we got four out of that one. Okay. I'm lining them up so that I can select them all. Okay. Then we're going to select them all, and we probably want to get them the same color so they'll print out together. So you can go over here to Color Sync and just move them all to one color. Doesn't matter what color unless you're going to do two different kinds. And if anybody knows an easier way to color sync them, let me know. I would love to know that tip. Okay. Now, let's see, what did I do next? We want to make more than just these. So, let's go to my layers. I grouped them together just so I can move them around. Okay, now since I still have them grouped, I'm going to duplicate. There they are. Okay, but you know what we're going to do with these? Make them a little bit smaller. It's always good to decorate with different sizes. Okay, and then I could probably do one more. Duplicate. Take it and size it down. Okay. Now, the next tip I'm going to give you is when you go to make it, and I hope I don't lose it because I didn't bother saving it since I already had. You can rearrange these a little bit better to where you can actually get more on the page depending on how you're going to be taking them off. But once I learned that tape trick, and this may not help any, but it's going to save material if nothing else. I even was able to turn some and fit them in closer together by doing that. Okay, let's see, these last ones. Oh, I could have left those others like they were and probably gotten all of these. But I'm going to move them to another mat so we don't have to print as many. And I'm going to position them as I go. But you've got my drift about this way. We're only going to have to be cutting twice. Yep, it took my confirm. Where did it take it? Might not fit there. So we're going to move this up here. And maybe it'll fit down here. If I turn this one. Move it up a little bit, and it fits. Okay, so I could go ahead and do all the rest, but you realize what I'm trying to show you. Remember that if I cancel out of what I'm doing here to print, then it loses all of this arrangement. So you want to make sure if you were wanting to save some. But if not, guys, look over here. When you pulled that one up, you're only using like 2¼ inch of material by just moving those few. So it's not really a big deal if you don't move them. But I had like 6 sheets of them that I printed out. Or designed. I didn't print them all out. Or cut them. I always just say the word print. Okay, but does that help any? I hope everybody learned something new from that, or how easy it is to make snowflakes with your window cleans. Or with any material, actually. Vinyl, anything. So, have a great day. And I will see you on the upswing. Love you.